Hi guys, so today I thought we would do September favorites, and at the end of the video I'm actually going to be answering some of your frequently asked questions about lighting and my camera and whatnot, because I know most of you guys are probably just here to see the makeup, but I know a lot of you guys do beauty videos and things like that yourselves, and I've gotten so many questions about that, especially lately. So after I was telling you guys about my lighting journey and trying to improve the quality of my videos and whatnot, and I know how frustrating that can be, so I'm going to address all that stuff at the end of the video for those who are interested. But right now, let's get to the goods, the makeup, well, beauty products. So the first product I wanted to talk about is this Urban Decay Vitamin Infused, okay, it's a long name, B6 Vitamin Infused Complexion Prep Spray. And I thought this product was such a breath of fresh air because it actually does, for me, what it claimed to do. So it reduces redness, minimizes pores, and absorbs oil. Now, I mainly purchased this because of the redness factor, which I have redness in my skin. I didn't really think I had a huge problem with enlarged pores, but after using this, now when I don't use it, I do notice my pores more. It's kind of a blessing and a curse. So I think this really does shrink your pores a lot. I mean, I have to get up close in the mirror to really, really see them when I use this. So you basically are supposed to apply this before your makeup, even before your moisturizer, which took me a little while to get in the hang of doing that. And then at any point throughout the day, you can use it to just refresh your skin. And it just feels really good too. It's an ultra, ultra fine mist. You can almost barely feel it. Like, you spray it on your skin and then you're supposed to hold it like 8 to 10 inches away, but I never do. I just kind of like douse my face in it. Yeah, Urban Decay, keep making these facial sprays because I will keep buying them. The next product is something that is a little out of the ordinary for me. It's a high-end foundation by Dior. This is the Dior Skin Air Flash Foundation. And it's basically like an airbrush type of foundation without the actual airbrush, just a spray can form. And I have been wearing this in every one of my videos since I purchased it, and it's not like an everyday foundation for me because of the fact that it's expensive, so I don't want to use it up, and also because it is a little bit difficult to apply. I'll explain in a second, but I'm going to tell you the things I like about it. First of all, I think that it looks like second skin. Like, it looks so naturally flawless. It's a very thin, ultra thin, liquidy formula, so it just is such a nice departure from the thicker thicker foundations that I've been using and stuff. And it just makes your skin look so, so flawless. It's especially on camera. Like, I really, really like it for filming videos. The downside is you will notice a little bit of a mist, like a makeup cloud, hanging around after you've sprayed it on your face. Which, okay, I have tested it out and like wiped down my desk or my makeup table after applying it, and I don't find any more makeup residue on there than I typically do with like powder foundations and stuff like that. So I feel like the mist must be settling somewhere. I don't want all my furniture to, you know, be linen colored, which is the name of the shade that I wear, 201 Linen. But right now it doesn't really seem to be like settling on stuff. Like, it's weird. You would think it would. I know a lot of people will spray it onto their hand and then apply it with a brush. It gets a little lost in translation from your hand to the brush to your skin. I feel like you're just wasting product, and with something that's pricey like this, I don't really want to do that. So we'll see. I will figure it out. I'm determined to figure it out, and then I will include it in a video for sure. But in the meantime, I have been loving the actual results of the Dior Skin Air Flash spray foundation. Moving on to a fragrance. This is actually a fragrance by La Vanilla Laboratories, and it's called Healthy Grapefruit. I kept the little box because the size of this is tiny and I didn't want to lose it. I actually cashed in my Sephora points. I cashed in like 100 points to get this. It smells amazing, and you wouldn't think that the combination of vanilla grapefruit would work for, I don't know, to me that sounds more like a summery fragrance, but it totally works for fall. I've been wearing it every single day. Something about it is rich enough that it works for fall. Maybe in the winter it would be a little too light, but I just love the way that it smells. So I will give you a close-up, but I think you pretty much get the gist of what that looks like. And then, let's see, moving on to a bronzer. I feel like I try a new bronzer like every month. What is with that? I don't know. I do like them for different things. This one I love for contouring. This is the Bahama Mama Bronzer by The Balm. I actually ordered this from Holt Look, so I got a really good deal on it, and right away when I It came in the mail. I was obsessed with the packaging, so cute. And it is really a true brown tone, which I like a lot. It is so soft, it is so easy to blend into the skin. It almost blends into the skin like a cream. It's really buttery and smooth. I love it so, so much. This is the Pureology Hydrate Shampoo and Conditioner for dry color treated hair. And I started using this before I colored my hair when I had my blonde hair because I knew I was gonna be doing something different with it and I wanted to make sure it was healthy before I, colored it and whatnot. And I love this stuff so much, especially the conditioner, because it has a really like pepperminty type of scent. It's really invigorating and I just love it so much. It works really well. This stuff does not build up on my hair at all. That's a close-up of what the bottle looks like in case you're going to, you know, look for these at Ulta or something. That's where I found these. Has it kept my hair from fading? Well, I think it has. It has helped. The thing is, I mean, my hair has faded. I had extremely light, I mean, my hair was almost platinum in some areas. And when you do color like really, really light hair, it does have a tendency to fade. My thing is, I work out. When I work out, I sweat. So when I sweat, I gotta shampoo my hair, like, cause that's just gross otherwise. So with shampooing a lot, your color will fade a little bit. It's just, you know, a fact of life. But now when I go in from now on, it will have more to kind of grab onto now that my color is darker, so it probably won't fade as much next time and the time after, if that makes sense. Anyway, the shampoo and conditioner are really good. That's my point. Pureology Hydrate. So I thought I would go through and show you guys the combination of products that I've really been loving for my eyes this month. I'm gonna start off with eyeshadows, and the three big ones this month were definitely more of like warmer fall tones and then some more purpley tones. This one is called Brown Script. This is by MAC. Actually, all of these eyeshadows are by MAC. This color is just so beautiful. It's like a terracotta brown and it's just perfect for the crease. If you have really, really fair skin, I may not recommend this one just because it pulls such a red, orangey type of tone. But you could do like Saddle maybe and get the same type of effect. And then this one is Embark, which I really forgot about for a very long time and I recently rediscovered it. This is beautiful in the crease as well and more of like for outer V definition. So that's what that one looks like. And it looks great on any eye color because it's brown, but it also has some purple tones. So it kind of is universal. It looks great with every eye color, I think. And then this one is Sketch, which is more of a purpley color, maroon color. You can check out my latest tutorial if you want to see how I used all these colors together. So you can see that one's more of like a deeper maroon shade. These are just perfect autumn colors. I love, love, love these. And then as far as what I'm wearing on my eyes today, I actually have this pigment by MAC on my lids. This is called Copper Sparkle, and this is so gorgeous. It looks like crushed up minerals, like flecks of copper, and it's cool because as with a lot of these pigments, you can apply it a lot of different ways. Today, I just have it patted onto the lid, just a teeny tiny bit of it, with Fix Plus just to get a little sparkle, or if you went like, if you put more on your brush and then applied it with Fix Plus, and you can see like what it looks like on my finger. It's crazy. It almost gives you like a foiled look. It's not even translating as much as it is in person. It looks very, very metallic, like just a copper penny. It's gorgeous. So we're gonna talk about lip products. And I have to say, I really don't have that many to show. I have three. So that, for me, that's not very many. But this first one is a lip liner. This is by MAC and it's called Night Moth. And this is a great one to have if you really want to try out the dark lip trend, because this can really go with almost any darker lip. You could even wear this with like a red and get a really cool like ombre lip type of look. So I'm going to swatch that for you. I'll show you all the lip swatches at the end, but it's really just a super, super deep purpley like berry color, but I really like it though just to get that vampy look. And this liner is definitely gorgeous with the other lipsticks I'm going to be showing too. The first one I wanted to show is by MAC. I showed this in a recent, actually both of these in a recent tutorial as well. This one is called Ho and it's from the Rihanna Hearts MAC collection. When I first got this in the summer, I thought it was a little strange. Well, I ordered it thinking, okay, I'll wear that in the fall. I have fallen in love with this color. The retro matte finish is unbelievable. Like, I have other darker lipsticks like this by MAC. Diva is one that I have. I honestly think this one applies so much better than Diva. Like, it's so even, it enhances the lips. So this next one is called Black Cherry by Milani. And it looks like it's almost a black lipstick, but it does have some plummy tones in there, and it's not as dark when you actually apply it than it looks like in the tube, but it is definitely a vampy lipstick. Like, don't get me wrong, it's intense. And that is what these two look like next to each other, so you can kind of get an idea. Definitely been loving these, you know, Cabernet shades and then the really, really rich plum shades as well. So I'm going to show you swatches of these. Okay, good. They're not getting too washed out on camera. So this one is Night Moth lip liner and Ho lipstick, and then that is the Black Cherry lipstick by Milani, which you can see has some shine to it. Okay, so that is gonna do it for my actual beauty products. I hope I'm not forgetting anything. The foundation was a big one though. This is big for me because I've been using drugstore foundations for a while, so I was excited about that. So I'm gonna talk about lighting really quickly. So a lot of you guys know, a lot of the videos that I did this year, last year, I filmed them in front of this window over here. I knew I had to get some lights and, you know, invest in some other lighting because I just couldn't rely on the sun all the time. It's just not a sunny day every day, let's face it. So, I basically typed in studio lights into Amazon, and pretty much the first set that popped up is the one that I got. Just a basic two-stand, I don't have them set up anymore, I'll explain that. But it's basically, you know, just like a big soft box, which is like a big black box, and then your light bulb is inside, and then there's like a sheet that covers the front, so it gives you that diffused light. I thought, okay, my problem solved. I invested in this professional lighting. It's gonna take care of all of my problems, right? Wrong. I basically realized that it was doing weird things. It was making my foundation look lighter than it really was, which you guys noticed, and you're like, why are you wearing foundation that's not matching your body? I was like, I'm not. It's the lights. It also made my face look really shiny when it wasn't shiny. There's no contrast in the picture. It looked very one-dimensional. It looked very dingy, kind of. I just didn't like the way the softbox lights worked, but something good came out of it. I decided one day to take the light bulbs out of the studio lights. I put them in these little light stands, which I'm gonna show you in a second. They're really basic. They're from Target. They have like the one, two, three bulbs on them like this. Who would have thought just that little tiny change made a world of difference? I actually have two of those lamps, one on this side of the camera and one on this side of the camera. I'm gonna show you in a second. But basically I don't have the light bulbs facing me, otherwise it would look like this. So I have it faced the other way. I did notice that it was a little bit of a greenish tint, which I noticed when it was actually in the softbox, so I added a light bulb on this side that is a warmer light bulb to balance it out, add some warmth to the picture, and make my skin look like human skin, not like green skin lizard person. If you are filming right up against like a wall, a white wall, it will reflect and diffuse the light back a lot better. But as you can see, I do not film up against a wall, so I just have a makeshift reflector over here propped up on my desk. You can purchase professional photography reflectors. The ones I've seen are anywhere from $50 to $60 and up. This is just a piece of foam board from Michaels, and it costs anywhere from like $3 to $5 depending on the size you get. I think it works really well, and it just helps to basically reflect the light back onto my face, eliminating harsh shadows, and just gives you a nice even illuminated look. And I can just throw this behind the door when I'm not using it, so it doesn't take up a lot of space. And then these are the two lamps I was talking about, one on either side, and then my tripod is just a really, really inexpensive one from Best Buy. So I have two of the studio bulbs I was talking about on this side, and then on this side I have one, and I have them turned off, otherwise it would throw off the camera, but it just gives off that kind of cool light. Looks like that. And then the warmer one I mentioned is up here, and this is a GE Reveal light bulb. And that's what that one looks like. So it's just more of a warmer tone. I'm gonna copy all the info off of these light bulbs and put them into the description box down below for anyone who's interested. The camera that I use is a Canon Rebel T4i, and I use a wide angle lens most of the time, except for when I'm filming the really zoomed in shots of my eye. In tutorials, I use the standard lens that came with the camera. So that is pretty much it. So in conclusion, if you are having frustrations with lighting, I have been there. It's very, very frustrating. I would suggest just dedicating a day to sitting down and experimenting, do some lighting tests, film a few clips with lighting different ways and figure out what works for you. And don't try to figure it out all on the day you want to film a video. It never works. It never works for me anyway. So, you know, do a little prep work, do a little experimentation. Anyway, I hope that helped you guys, for those of you that film videos. And if you don't, I hope you enjoyed this favorites video. Lots of fun stuff coming your way that I'm really excited about. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys!